Oh, good. You're here.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good.
Admired Miranda, indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective. The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
Sometimes, when you meet someone who's going to change your life, you just know it, I guess. Also, you've got parents coming to see the show, right? At 20 bucks a ticket, it's gotta be true love.
Wow. A romantic and a cynic. That actually kinda helps me. Thanks.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Your eye looks fabulous. Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah, sure. Okay, get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right? That's the nicest backpack. Rachel looks so happy here. There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now. I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously? Hey now, sharing is caring. Rachel, is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks. So? Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
How about a belt instead?
Perfect.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Is that a rhetorical question?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Fuck yes. I was born to ditch.
I hoped you'd say that. Now about that eye, that is a hell of a battle scar. Do you want me to cover it up with some makeup?
Are you kidding? This is a badge of honor.
Respect. Let's get the hell out of here.
You sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or?
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right. Well?
What the hell am I getting into here?
Where does this thing go?
North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Rachel wants me to pull up a chair. Maybe one of these crates. Whoa, Nathan's dad is a Terminator? That totally checks out. Thing's heavier than it looks. Guess I should sit down. All right, Chloe. You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool. Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people do? Nice Rachel we're having.
What?
I mean, weather. It's nice weather.
It sure is. So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
Hey, so I want to say thanks.
For pulling you out of school?
No, dummy. Thanks for last night.
Ah.
If you hadn't shown up.
Assholes abound in Arcadia Bay.
I owe you. That's for sure.
Is that why you came along?
Are you suggesting I should need a reason to ditch school?
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well, I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
Try again. I'm going to need more to go on than that.
Joyrides with me aren't fun?
Joyrides to where again?
Life needs a little mystery, Chloe. Let's do something fun.
Okay, I'm listening.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is...
a lie?
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Sounds fun. You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu.
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
I don't buy the ambidextrous claim.
No? Well, that's too bad, because it's true.
Prove it. Sign your name with both hands.
Sign where? Seriously?
All the bad girls do it. Come on. Damn.
I'm afraid the lie was New York. I'm a Cali girl, born and raised.
So New York's on the bucket list.
Broadway, here I come.
Cool.
Okay, your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game. I used to want to be a pirate when I grow up. I kind of still do.
Arr.
I used to love country music when I was a kid. Now it makes me want to throw up. Literally.
That's weird.
I once broke my hand punching Stephanie Kowalski in fifth grade.
No way.
Bitch took my yoo-hoo, knocked her the fuck out.
I see you like to write notes to yourself.
Helps me stay focused.
Also, sweet scar. You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella? Who says that?
It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. I'm not sure why country music makes you throw up.
I'm a complex girl, Rachel.
I think it's probably true. Also, I kinda like the Dixie Chicks.
You and David both. No accounting for taste.
Who's David?
He's, the guy my mom's seeing, I guess.
Oh.
And you don't like him. It's still so weird that she's dating someone. My dad and my mom, they were totally in love. You can tell how fucked up she is now just by how she's settling for David. He's this total hard-ass ex-military jagoff type. Like, the opposite of my dad.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. David has no respect. He acts like I'm some kind of problem to solve. Sometimes I am a problem, though.
That's a load of bullshit.
What do you mean?
You're not a problem, Chloe. You're a person. It sounds like the only problem is David. You need to hit him where it hurts.
The only thing that David loves has four wheels and a four-barrel carburetor.
Oh, God. A muscle car?
I'm probably going to steal it soon, so...
Let me know if you need an accomplice. Of course you wanted to be a pirate. Sail the open seas.
Buckle swash.
Plunder secret treasure. So, pirate. Obviously true.
Maybe you'd like to be my first mate.
Oh. Are you accepting applications?
Considering it.
Now, about this broken hand story. It's not that I don't think you could knock Stephanie Kowalski out. A bitch takes your yoo-hoo, she's gotta get got.
Damn straight.
But, you didn't get that scar from punching someone.
No.
That scar is from a distal radius fracture.
So you're a physician now?
Last summer I performed a one-woman Doctor Who homage entitled Weeping Angel.
Wait, what?
The point is, I know that the scar you've got comes with breaking your wrist when you fall. Like, from a skateboard?
Yeah.
I guess 6 years ago?
Seven. Well, shit. I always thought I was a good liar.
Good thing you're pretty. So, if my math is correct, you told me two truths and one lie.
What? You expected me to cheat?
Winners make their own rules, Chloe.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
Well, I'm impressed.
I bet it's hard to impress Chloe Price. I'm gonna feel good about that one. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You played the game. And not everyone would admit to wanting to be a pirate.
But eye patches are so cool.
And rum is delicious. Also, you told me about that dickwad David. Now he's on my shit list too.
Hell yeah. Mustache brain won't know what hit him.
I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
I'm just not really into touchy-feely shit. But I feel like I can trust you.
Yeah?
I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music. Hey, wanna listen?
Thank you. Bracelet. I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach, or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later. What brought that on? Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here! What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump! Fuck it!
Actually a pretty nice view. Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
Another one?
I like games. Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games.
What's your point?
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out which one. This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up. That blows. Well, shit. That was my last quarter. You?
Quarterless.
Damn.
Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh yeah? Let's see what you got.
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her.